two. So first, it's double cleansing. Two, it's hydration. And then three, usually we'd go in with a sheet mask. Hello, hi, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while. I know I always start my videos this way, but welcome. Today I'm going to share with you some of the skincare products that you can use, some of the K-beauty products that you can use for better and more glowy, luminous skin as a black person. Believe it or not, black people actually age the same way as Asian people. And I actually had to travel to Europe. I mean, from living in Africa, South Africa, living in Europe and then coming to Asia, only then did I learn all of this. And obviously, because I am a chemist, so I've noted some similarities. So since coming to Asia, I actually realized that the same routine or the same steps that Asian people use to keep their skin looking amazing, those are some of the things that we can do as melanin rich black people to actually achieve the same, you know, flawless glass skin. There are a few fundamentals that you need to know in order to make sure that you can use products to their full efficiency. The first thing would be to double cleanse. Double cleansing is absolutely a must. It is important. For those who don't know, double cleansing is using first going in with an oil to cleanse your skin and then going in with the foam, you know, depending on what kind of skin you have. People with drier skin might want to go in first with like an oil and then go in with like a creamy cleanser. People with oily skin might prefer to go in with an oil and then, well, an oil based cleanser and then go in with a foam, right? So there's so many things on the markets that you can use. You can use a cleansing balm. I like the vanilla one. I will link it down on the description. The vanilla one is absolutely fantastic. There's other brands as well who have a cleansing balm, so you can try a cleansing balm. One of my favorites is from my own brand, Rare Aesthetics. I love this. I cannot fully show everything, but it's almost empty sample. It's absolutely amazing for just emulsifying the sunscreen, removing the dirt, the oil, without stripping my skin. And then my favorite to go in next after the oil is this. This is the holy grail of Korean cleansing. Well, it's quite popular, but I'm sure there's many others. A lot of people like this because it doesn't have a smell, like a strong smell, and it doesn't even sting your eyes. You can literally open your eyes while the product is all over your face and it will not make your eyes teary. So a lot of people like it for that, and also it doesn't dry out your skin. When you use it, it doesn't dry out your skin. It leaves your skin just soft and smooth. So it's really up to you. I know they call it Good Morning Gel Cleanser, but I also use this in the evening. It just depends on how my skin is feeling. You know, in the winter, I do tend to go in with the oil cleanser a bit more. Even in the mornings, I would go in with the cleanser because even though I've got oily skin in the summer, it's very dry in the winter, and sometimes in the summer it's also dry. So just depends on what your skin is going through, but like using an oil and then going in with a foam is the reason why they call it double cleansing. Step number two when it comes to K-beauty basic routine of skincare is hydration. Hydration, 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 hydration. You need to hydrate your skin, and not just by drinking water, but also by using a mist, a toner, an essence, anything with humectants. You can look out for hyaluronic acid, which is everywhere these days, or glycerin, which has always been there all these years. Okay, so that's what you really need. You need to pull in moisture into your skin, and humectants really do that. Right now, I'm enjoying another sample by Rare Aesthetics. This is really a simple hydrating toner. It's got niacinamide, it's got cucumber, and it's also got leucorrhiz. So sometimes you can use a hydrating toner that's got like actives in it, you know, so that, you know, your next routine, you don't, or the next step doesn't necessarily have to have the same ingredients, okay? So this is my favorite. This is really, really nice. You can use a cotton pad to actually dab that into your skin. You can use a spray, whatever it is. You can use a serum. You just need to hydrate your skin with humectants, pulling in all the moisture back into your skin because you've just washed it, okay? Three, usually we'd go in with a sheet mask. Like, sheet masks are really it. Like, when I first came to Asia and I went for a facial, they put a sheet mask on my face. I had never seen it anywhere in the world. Obviously, I was used to like clay masks, you know, that's it. I had never seen a sheet mask before. And the funny thing is, they've been used for hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands of centuries in Asia. So when I came here and they put on a sheet mask, it was made out of pomegranate. I was like, what is this? I need to buy these, and I did. So this one is just the basic one with hyaluronic acid. It really, really, you know, reinforces moisture into your skin. And the great thing about these is they're so easy. You can just pop this in the fridge like a night before, and then in the morning, you know, you can use this to de-puff your face after you've double cleansed. Well, in the morning you don't necessarily have to double cleanse, you just need to cleanse depending on what your skin is feeling like. But even at night you can really use them after you use a toner or a serum. This is great. This one is a basic one with hyaluronic acid. I live by sheet masks. After the sheet masks, then you can use like a treatment serum if that's, you know, what you want to do. You can do that, but like I said, because a lot of my actives are already in my toner and in my moisturizer, I'm not gonna go in with a serum for now unless I really feel the need to do that. You can look out for ingredients such as honey, snail, mucin. You know, you can use a toner with that, or niacinamide, really up to you, okay? So the next thing would be a moisturizer. This one is quite popular at the moment. This one by Some By Me. AHA, BHA, PHA, 30 Days Miracle Cream. You see, this one has active. It's got, well, it's got actives. It's got alpha hydroxy acids, which are your lactic acids, you know, your mandelic acid, your glycolic acid. And then it's also got the BHAs, which could be salicylic acid. And then it's also got the PHAs as well. So this is infused with a lot of actives. So if you're gonna use this as a moisturizer, it's better not to use a serum that has actives, or like an exfoliating serum, because then you're also gonna exfoliate over here, and we do not want over exfoliation, okay? This also has 70% centella. Centella is amazing for just soothing and calming the skin. Absolutely fantastic. I love it. I really enjoy this cream. I love the texture. It's absolutely gorgeous, and it's so minty fresh. It leaves me feeling super fresh. So highly recommend, linked in the description below, okay? So after we've done that for our morning routine, we can go in with a sunscreen, okay? Personally, I like physical sunscreens just because I've got acne-prone skin. So I found that a lot of, you know, zinc, well, a lot of the physical sunscreens, they've got zinc in it, and zinc really helps to clear out my black marks. But to each their own, you know, it's really hard to find like a sunscreen that has zinc that just like easily absorbs into the skin. So it really depends on you. You must buy a sunscreen that you love so you can use it every single day. Remember, reapply every 2 hours. Yeah, and use the 2-finger rule to measure how much sunscreen you actually need. So this is one of my favorites. This is Isle's UV Protection Skin Radiant Cream. Amazing Korean brand. Absolutely love this. Here's another one that I'm currently enjoying. I know this is Japanese, but it's absolutely amazing and quite affordable. This is the Bio UV Aqua Rich Water Rich Milk. This one I would totally use now in the summer because it's quite humid right now, and this one just helps to suck up all the oil from the face, and it just leaves you matte the whole day. I don't really like the matte look, but sometimes it's very hot here, so sometimes I will use it, but I personally prefer this one because it gives me a dewy look. So if I'm not going anywhere, I'll definitely use this one for that dewy look because I'm at home. But if I have to go out, I will use this one because I've got oily skin and it's quite humid in the summer here. Okay, so that's it. So that's our morning routine, put down. When it comes to night, what you can do is, obviously you're not gonna put in sunscreen at the end of, at night. So after your moisturizer, you can go in with like a sleeping pack. This is usually like some sort of like a mask that you can leave on. You can leave on overnight and it just like really hydrates. This one I like, it's from Apeo and it's like a fresh potato pack. Korean people really love these packs, even Chinese people, even Japanese, people, they really love putting on, a pack, especially if your skin is like super dry, maybe dehydrated, feeling sensitive from over exfoliation, all of that. You can just put this on, go to sleep, and you wake up with the smoothest skin. And the best part about it, in the morning, you just need to rinse your face off and boom, you are ready for the day. So this you can use when your skin is feeling super sensitized. Like this one says, fresh potato sleeping pack helps to soothe heated and sensitized skin comfortably. I really love this. It's almost done. Or if your skin is okay, what you can do is, after you've put on your moisturizer, after you've done moisturizer, you can do a barrier protection cream. This one is quite popular and available everywhere. This is the Madecassoside cream. It's also from Apeo. It's got centella leaf water, 40%, and it's got 0.1% of the Madecassoside. Yeah, okay. So this one says it's derived from nature, strengthens skin barrier by providing protective film to skin. So that's what a barrier protection cream does. It usually protects your skin and stops anything from going in. This is why you would use this as a last step, because after you use this, nothing can really penetrate. So what you can do is you can use a barrier cream, or you can use Vaseline, believe it or not, or you can use an oil, depending on what you want. You can use like rosehip if you are suffering from like hyperpigmentation. You can use squalene if you just want like moisture. Just depends on what your skin needs. So you can either use a barrier protection cream, you can use some petroleum jelly, or you can use an oil to seal in everything so that while you sleep, you lose a lot of water. It's great for, preventing TEWL, which is, the water that we sleep, the water that our skin loses while we sleep. So basically that's it. It's quite simple. Okay. So the first thing you need to do is double cleanse, especially after a long day in the morning. Just a one cleanse is enough because it's in the morning. You probably don't have sunscreen and all of that. So you can double cleanse at night. So important. Second thing is to hydrate, add a lot of water. And what some people actually do is that what you can do is actually do 5 layers of your humectant. So if you've got like a toner, you can actually apply it 5 times. So you apply it the first time, you apply it again, tap it into your face like that, you apply it again. Even if it's a serum, you can do that. Try 5 layers to really, really get that extra, water into your face. Or if you don't do that, then you can always go in with like a sheet mask because it's gonna stay on your face. And what's great about sheet masks is that in the morning you can pop it on while you have your tea, organizing your day and all of that. And at night, just for reflecting or just like coming down your day, you can do that. So these are pretty doable and you can actually buy affordable ones. So the first thing would be to double cleanse, as I've said. Second thing would be to hydrate. 3, use some sheet masks, and there's different types depending on what your skin needs. For me, I really don't rely on sheet masks to have actives. I just use them just to add more water into my face. Okay. And then the fourth thing would be to moisturize, depending on what your skin needs. And then after moisturizing, going in with sunscreen. After sunscreen, if it's at night, you can go in with a barrier cream. obviously no sunscreen at night, and then go in with an oil if that's what you want to do, barrier cream or oil, and basically that is all that's there for it. And then what you can do is every in a week you can exfoliate 2 to 3 times. Don't exceed 3 times. You exfoliate your skin. There's a lot of products that you can use to actually exfoliate your skin. And even the exfoliating products, don't use them every day. Like this moisturizer, I wouldn't use this every day. I know they say 30 days miracle cream, but this would be like exfoliating your skin every single day. This is not a very gentle moisturizer that you would want to use every single day. So look for one that would probably maybe just have centella and no exfoliating ingredients so that you can use it every single day. But basically that is all there is to it. Trust me, if you can follow these steps and watch your skin over like a month, it'll change drastically. It'll change completely. SPF, so important. Proper cleansing, super beneficial. Hydrating your skin, giving it water, absolutely amazing. Thank you for watching. Comment down below, let me know what you think. Which of these products have you heard about? Which products do you like? And I will see you soon, darling.